What's up, guys? Awesome Nerd Show here, back again playing on Pokemon Evolved, I believe is what it's called, on Ark Survival Evolved, of course. And we're here at our little lonesome base. They've made very minor improvements on. I haven't got to play the game very much. But if you did see the last episode, since then I got this Pidgeot, which I bought through the little machine right here. With the coins and stuff. I didn't tame one because, as you can see, I just have the two Pokemon that I had before. Because taming, I have not figured out yet at all. Like, I see other people play this game, and they, like, punch a Pokemon twice and it gets knocked out. I cannot get that to happen. So I don't know what's wrong with me. But what I do want to do is... What do I have on me? My guy looks pretty weighed down. Oh, just a bunch of arrows and stuff, which I do need to drop off some arrows. So what's been taking me so long is, first of all, I've been trying to find a Pokemon, a dinosaur, actually, because there's not many Pokemon that you can ride on. Like, Pidgeot's one, and you can do kind of like basic bird stuff. But you can't, like, ride Ivysaur. You can't ride on him. Can't ride on Machop unless they change something. Nope. Or Machamp, I always call him Chop for some reason. Let's go ahead and drop some of these arrows. We'll just stick one in there, I guess. And then we'll run over here and actually stick these berries, since I don't really need those. So I put this up to get spoiled meat and stuff to make Tranks and everything. Thinking that maybe Tranking Pokemon would work better. But not exactly getting enough berries to be able to do that. I also turned on, I may not have built any. Actually, we'll just take those. Go ahead and take these out. Just take one foundation to kind of mark stuff. But I'm trying to find a new place to build. So I do have the S Plus turned on. So I do have the ability to, you know, pick up structures and stuff like that. But now it's just trying to figure out where to build. So as far as Pokemon go, or dinosaurs, I'm going to call everything Pokemon. I want something that will help gather berries, but there are no trikes, at least that I can find. There's no trikes. I'm not exactly sure about Brawnos. The only thing that I have been able to find, which since the game's come out, there have been a lot of updates. Like, I know there's new Pokemon, but I have not seen any besides the normal Pokemon, and I don't know if I need to do a Dino Wipe on the server for them to appear, or what the deal is. Like, I just keep seeing the exact same Pokemon, but again, as I watch other people's videos to try and figure out what to do and stuff, they have all different types of Pokemon. Like, I just see the exact same ones, and I've, aside from the snow biome up north, I have flown all over this island looking for different types of Pokemon and stuff, and I haven't found anything new or different, except for at what was Carno Island or Death Island or whatever. That's the only thing. So there are Spinos, but those don't gather berries. I'm not sure about the Ponytas. I know you can ride them, but I don't know if they gather. I have no clue about the Xerneases. Like, I know on the Pokemon, or on the page for this, these Nidokings are funny. They're like, or they were at least, super aggressive. So as I would fly over, they would all start, like, hovering or, like, running towards me. Even though I'm on the up in the air and stuff, but they may have changed it. But so all that there is anymore is the redwoods, and then the swamp, like over here, are the only things that have their normal dinosaurs. So I could get like a Parasaur, but they're kind of too big for what I want and slow. I have no clue if Fiume is. I may just have to try and find one and knock it out. But again, I would like need Trank arrows for that, which I think I did make a bunch of narcotics. And I had Trank arrows to try and knock stuff out, but one of those stupid little new dinosaurs that, to tame, you, like, put stuff in, berries or something in your last slot. Ooh, there's a Charmander over there. And, oh, I'm out of stamina and not at a good spot either. I did not realize. Hopefully no snakes come up and attack me. I forget what I was even saying. I'll get flying up here so I'm out of danger. And so I just, like this, the thing stole berries from me and I supposedly tamed it, but I could never find it again. So there's that. And then it continued, there was multiple around, and then it stole all my narco. Oh, there's a snake coming for me. All my, narcotics and stuff. Or trank arrows is what I'm trying to say. So I lost all that I had. I don't know if I've done more since then or not. I can't remember. But yeah, I just need something that'll help gather berries, because I can't by hand gather enough berries to, to like get more Pokemon stuff, like trank arrows and everything. So I need to find something that I can find to gather berries and stuff. But what I mostly want to do is find a new spot to, build at and everything. So, that's what I've been trying to find, a new place. Like, I want a place that is, widely accessible. Like, I see, I think that, Nidoking over there is mad at me. That's widely accessible to a bunch of Pokemon. And, access to a bunch of other stuff. But I don't know exactly where that good place to build would be. So I think I'll just fly around a little bit and try and find a spot to call home and start a permanent place. And when I do, we'll come back and maybe do some building again. And I have the S-plus stuff turned on, so have a bunch of S-plus structures and all sorts of stuff. So I will find a place I want to build, and I'll be back when I get there. Okay guys, so I think I found the spot I want to build, and it's up on this cliff over here. If you want to see on the map, you can see like where I'm at here. Of course, we have the swamp just there. There's a bunch of wooded area. So again, the swamp, which has all the like a bunch of dinosaurs and everything. So we have this whole little water area. Of course, the what people like to call Spino Cove or whatever. And so I thought this area would be kind of cool because it's not exactly flat. Of course, over there it's flatter. Well, let's look over here. Because, I mean, flatter would be nicer, but it just depends. Actually, yeah, this area doesn't look too bad. Oh, goodness. Apparently, Pidgeys are very aggressive. I did not know that. Seems to be kicking my butt, though. I don't know how I'm doing on it. Hopefully, it'll just leave me alone. Because I don't know how to kill it. Die! Don't kill me, though. So I've not had very good Oh, there we go. Oh, goodness. Here comes another one. I've never had problems with Pidgey before. Or Pidgeot, whatever you want to call it. Hopefully it'll just leave me alone. But yeah, I think I'll build in that area if I can get this these Pidgeys to leave me alone. I'll be able to start building. But like I said, I have the S+, so it'll give me, the ability to build in, like, unflat areas, stuff like that. But I think that's good because it's kind of center of the island, which I've usually always built along the ocean. So I'll be inland and stuff like that. Let's see. Maybe the Pidgey flew off or died or something. Oh no, it's flying around where... I guess I'll just have to deal if it comes back and attacks me. Yeah, so I think I'll build in here, so I'll go ahead and just put down our first foundation. Worried about that Pidgey. Of course, there's Nine Tails and all sorts of stuff along here too. So we'll just put down our very first foundation. Of course, now I need stuff to build. So I'll probably craft some stuff and get at least a foundation put down over here. So I'll get building that, and then we'll bring it back to start building the base and everything. So I'll be back. Okay, guys, so I got a basic structure laid out here. I think this is a 3x4, and then I have a 2 on the front. So it's not going to be finished or anything. I'm just getting stuff where it'd be, like, you know, safe for the night and everything. So I got some ramps put down. Ooh, I like how those ramps line up. I like the S+ because it you can build pretty much almost anywhere and stuff. So I got this chest and all sorts of stuff in it. So we go ahead and start with some walls of windowed and regular. So of course gonna go with like a normal like layout as most people would do, like that. And then of course the rest will fill in with just the plain stone walls. If this Tyranitar is in the way, or Tyrantum or whatever, get out of the way. Walk off, please. Nope. There we go. Yes, walk out of my base. Oh, I was like, what is that? I was like, is that a herd or something? Okay, let's quickly put walls up before more of them walk in. There we go. So at least I have that. Of course, I'll build it up higher because I want to put, I left 2 here so I can put a door, like dino door on the front. So that's why it's a 2, but for now, I'll go ahead and just put, I guess I'll do a window since that's what I have and that's backwards. So here's the nice thing, you can hit E and then of course pick it up and then try it again. And now it's facing the right way. And then in my inventory, or I guess it's not in my inventory. I'll probably eventually put ramps out this side too. I like that whole design type thing. So I'm put those back, grab the door frame and the door. Just so I can have this put on the front. And then of course we'll put the door. So this will be, like I said, a temporary door until I can get more built. And now we'll finally put and store that metal. Go ahead and put the ceilings on. And like I said, as you can see for now, it'll just be a 1 high. Go ahead and get some water. I was running out of water and kept dying almost. I don't like 1 high, so that's why this is definitely going to be temporary. Hopefully I don't mess anything up too bad, but that's the good thing about S+, is that if you mess it up, you can just pick it up and redo it again. So of course, these are the first mods I've ever done and stuff. Yay. So of course now Pidgeot's flying around like crazy out there. Wait, is that one of the... Oh, it is. It is one of the automatic doors. I didn't realize that. So if I can find Pidgeot now. So the bad thing is these aren't S+. Because I need to pick it up and put it inside the store stuff. Because Pidgeot doesn't have a lot of weight. So see, he can like barely fly around with me and stuff. So I need to build a thing. So go ahead and unwhistle him so he doesn't. So I'll get stuff moved in here, obviously. Oh yeah, keep forgetting that it's a walkthrough door. So I can put stuff in here, and of course I'll build off screen and everything. And then I did realize by with Pidgeot and everything that I can't get up here now. Let's see if I can run. Nope, that didn't work at all. If I could get up there. But you can actually pick the, like, Megaloceros or the deers or whatever. You can actually pick them up. And I didn't realize that with, like, the Pidgeot and stuff. So I can actually pick one up and drag it to where I need to. Because I kept, the other day when I played, I kept trying to tame it over in there. And that's when I kept getting attacked by stuff. And the things kept stealing my trank arrows and everything. But, of course, I'll put a window whatever things. This one won't be here, but I'll put the window things so you can shut the windows and whatnot. That's gonna creep me out thinking someone's here trying to steal stuff from me. But that's probably gonna be it. This is just a short video of me getting a new house location. Then I can obviously fence off a bunch of area here and then just get a bunch of dinos. I'll probably just do a fence railing. Of course, I like doing a lot of fences and stuff because I like the openness of it. But I'll probably just do in here because I don't want to close it off. But I don't want, of course, Pokemon just kind of sit there too. But I say I don't want anything falling off down here. But I forgot when you tame them, they just kind of sit there and stuff. So yeah, like, by the next video, I'll probably have this hopefully built bigger. Thing is, I need something that can carry weight, and Pidgeot is not gonna, let's see what its weight even is. 177, yeah. It's, I mostly just use it to, like, try and kill stuff. So I've been pumping weight, or, stamina, so it can fly, and then, melee damage on it and stuff. So I need to find something better. I know there's pterodactyls, and so you can kind of get their weight pretty good on those since there's no RGs and stuff like at the volcano there. But yeah, so that's probably gonna be it in our new little house here among the Pokemon. I'll of course have to figure out a way to move because I don't know if I can pick up Ivysaur, but I don't know about Machamp or anything. But yeah, I'll just have to get them picked up and move here to our new little base so we can look out onto the beautiful redwood. And if they ever update the like tree platforms and stuff, we can build a base right across over in there and stuff. But that's going to be it for this video of new base location stuff. So if you liked it, please leave a thumbs up. Hit the red subscribe button to see more, and we will see you next time.